Hello guys, welcome back again to my YouTube channel. My name is Christine, and on today's tutorial we want to look at how to prepare an interim payment certificate. Remember, we've done interim payment certificate and we've seen how to prepare an interim certificate, and then we've looked at various types of payment certificate that are used in construction. But now specifically today we want to look at the procedure of preparing an interim certificate. So guys, if you are new to this channel, kindly subscribe, share, like, and don't forget to leave a comment. Remember, this is a channel that deals with building works and civil works, and I've measured specifically on measurement of building and civil works and estimation and costing, and then on few aspects of civil and engineering that goes along with those areas. So guys, please subscribe, share, and like. Now let's look at the procedure of preparing an interim certificate. First, let's define what is an interim certificate. An interim certificate is that certificate that is used to pay the contractor when work is still in progress. You find that the contractor cannot wait for the entire period until he completes the work, and then we pay him as a client. So what we do, we have an interim certificate that is paid periodically or in stages according to the agreement. So if you agree it's periodically, then maybe you can do it after 1 month, 2 months, or 3 months, depending on how you agreed. And if you agree it is on stages, that is after a certain milestone has been achieved. So you can do it, maybe if it is a house, you can maybe decide to do the payment after a certain floor has been achieved, or after certain works have been done. So that is the purpose of an interim certificate. And guys, remember, for an interim certificate, 10% of the total amount that is supposed to be paid to the client is deducted. That is what we call retention money. So this retention money is going to be kept aside so that in case anything happens during the process of the construction, at least you have some money somewhere that you are going to use to complete the work. You know, sometimes these contractors, you pay them and then they disappear. Or after you've paid them, then you realize that certain work was not done to standard. So you are going to take the 10% retention money and then you are going to do the work with it. So guys, let's now proceed to preparing the procedure of preparing the interim certificate. Number one thing that AQS will do, AQS is the one who prepares the interim certificate, the quantity surveyor. So the quantity surveyor will visit the site. So that is when the agreed stipulated time has reached. If it was 1 month, or if it was after a certain milestone, if it has reached that time, the QS will visit the site and then carry out evaluations. So when he arrives at the site, number two thing that he's going to do, he'll do the measurement of the works, and then he'll record the materials on site which are purposely for the work. So he's going to measure. It was going to measure how much as the contractor done according to what was in the BQ. If it is concrete works, to what extent has the concrete works been done? So once he's done the measurement, he'll go back to the office with the report now and do quantifying the measured work. So he's going to prepare valuation. This is referred as preparation of valuation. So he's going to quantify the works, see what was in the BQ, what the contractor has done, and then is going to see that they are in the same line. And then number four thing that he's going to do, he'll prepare an interim certificate. That is if he agrees with the contractor valuation. So after he has checked everything and ensured that whatever he has measured on the site and what was on the BQ and what the contractor is claiming, they are okay, they agree, then he's going to proceed and prepare an interim certificate. And now this is where the video that I done on preparing an interim certificate comes in, because we are done, we had taken an example, and then from that example we prepared an interim certificate. So you can check it on my YouTube. And then once he prepares the interim certificate, number five thing is that he presents the certificate to the architect or the engineer for appraisal and approval. So this certificate must be presented to an engineer or an architect so that they can approve if the certificate goes hand in hand with the specifications. And then if they approve, then they are going to sign the certificate. Now, once the certificate has been signed, the last thing that is done is that the interim certificate is presented to the contractor who will represent it to the client for payment. Now, upon this stage, the client is going to pay the contractor because now everything has been approved. So guys, those are the steps that we follow as QS. If you want to prepare an interim certificate, those are the steps that we follow. Thank you guys for your time, and until next time, bye bye.